The midterm budget reallocates resources to alternative priority programs. This is for the purpose of achieving efficiency, value for money, and more developmental outcomes for such programs. The reallocation of internal savings was made on the basis of assessed performance by program and the likely expenditure outturn by the end of the financial year.
For the operational budget, internal savings were realized from expenditures such as daily subsistence allowance, we are not traveling, given the COVID-19 travel restrictions and social distancing measures. That's one. Savings were realized from goods and services for delayed activities and subsidies and current transfers. For the development budget, internal savings were realized from capital projects with below 10% execution rate and projects which have not yet started due to COVID. We all remember and know that there were restrictions that impacted negatively on some of this capital budget due to COVID restrictions during the first 6 months.
The Ministry of Education, Arts and Culture is allocated $326.4 million. Health and Social Services received $147.6 million for the procurement of pharmaceuticals, COVID-19-related expenditure, and the required optimal personnel. The Ministry of Gender Equality, Poverty Eradication, and Social Welfare is allocated an amount of $157.7 million to strengthen the coverage of social grants. The Electoral Commission of Namibia has been given $50 million for costs related to the conducting of the upcoming regional council and local authority elections. The Ministry of Public Enterprises is allocated a total of $75 million to support the operations of the Namibia Wildlife Resort and TransNamib, especially for the maintenance of the railway. The Ministry of Agriculture, Water and Land Reform got a share of $40 million for expenditure on water infrastructure. The Ministry of Defense and Veteran Affairs has been given $22.3 million earmarked to meet the funding needs for the Veterans Subvention Program. Other ministries that benefited from the reallocation are the Ministry of Industrialization and Trade and the Ministry of Home Affairs, Safety and Security.
This budget review avails deep expenditure revisions and protects spending, which enhances long-term growth and the provision of essential goods and services. To avoid sudden withdrawal of resources from the national programs dedicated to combating COVID-19, it enhances allocative efficiency by reallocating resources to priority programs where funding is required for better outcomes.
Timo Andreas, NBC News, Parliament.